In the last few lectures, we have been seeing how to design combinational logic circuits using MSI and LSI building blocks. Examples of the building blocks we use were multiplexers, decoders, programmable logic devices, especially PROM and PLA, programmable logic array. Of course, PAL also can be used, but then PAL also has a sequential part, the registers inside. Likewise, there are combination MSI, LSI building blocks in sequential circuits, like a 4-bit counter is an example. There are shift registers for 4-bit, 8-bit. These are examples which come under the category of MSI because of the number of gate equivalent gate functions. So, like reducing the number of gates, the motivation behind using MSI circuits in combinational design was to reduce the number of gates and make the circuits compact. Same motivation exists for reducing the sequential building blocks also. So, whenever you have a sequential circuit with flip-flops, either a JK flip-flop or a D flip-flop, whatever, there are individual flip-flops, individual ICs which have to be connected together, with all the problems of interconnectivity, the space, all those problems we talked about combinational. All these exist even in sequence circuits. So to that extent, we would like to minimize the number of ICs, the number of interconnections between these ICs, even for the sequential building blocks. So that's why instead of using flip-flops, we can use a register or a counter, which has the same function. A register, you know, is a bunch of flip-flops. Counter has flip-flops. And finally, when you make a circuit, it will have a combinational part with a very few ICs and sequential part with very few one or two ICs, and then the whole circuit becomes very compact. And if you go one step further, of course, you will have a circuit in which both combinational and sequential exist. Example was programmable array logic, in which registers also can be pushed in, so we can have a single IC which will implement the function. So in that direction, we talked about mapping a given function from a truth table onto an IC given, rather than minimizing for gates. How do you map a given corner map for a multiplexer based solution, for a ROM based solution? That's what we saw. Likewise, we will see how to map a given state table into a register or a flip-flop, a register or a counter. That's what we'll see today. So the example, we call this design of circuits using combination sequential building blocks, MSI sequential building blocks. So as an example, we'll take an arbitrary counter, arbitrary sequence counter using a 4-bit counter. 4-bit counter is available and we want to get an arbitrary sequence. When you say 4-bit counter, buy an IC for 4-bit counter, it will count sequentially from 0000 to FFFF, 1111, or opposite. Now, I want to use that but have my own sequence of states. That is the problem. So, this is the sequence I want, 0, 8, 2, 4, 6, etc. So, 4-bit counter, so up to 15, from 0 to 15 I can have. I am going to use a counter which is following specifications. You will have a clock, of course, any counter should have a clock, edge triggered. There is a loading feature, that means this counter will have inputs and outputs, parallel inputs and parallel outputs. So when I put a pattern here, DA, DB, DC, DD, a sequence of 1 and 0, I can load that into this counter by applying a pulse on the load, applying a signal and the load input. The values on DA, DB, DC, DD can be stored in the counter. Clear feature, all of us know, the clear feature will clear the counter, that means it will make it 0, 0, 0, 0. Count feature is it will count up or count down. So, when there is a signal given here, with every clock cycle, it will go by one count. Whether it is up or down, it is decided by this signal. So, this is 1 and this is 1, it will count up by 1, that means it was 1000, let us say as an example, and a clock arrives, and let us say this is 1 and this is 1, it will go to 1001. On the other hand, if there is 1000 and we have a count 1 and down this 0, after the next clock it will become 1 less than 1000, which is 0111. So I can count up, count down, I can load, I can clear all 4 bits. So inputs are available, outputs are available. Using this, how do I design a circuit which will go through this sequence? Today I will concentrate only on the sequential part. That means we will draw the state table and how to design it. But once we identify the combinational logic which will steer after, again it is a, see all problems are basic problems. We have a set of flip flops which store the state variables which are steered to the next state by means of a combinational logic. There is no change in that. Here also there has to be a combinational logic which will steer this counter from state to state as per this requirement. So that combinational part can again be implemented using MUXUS or PROM. So since I do not want to complicate, it is not exactly complicated problem becomes bigger to handle, I will assume for this discussion alone that we will still use the gate solution for the combinational logic, because I want to emphasize and concentrate on the register steering, how the register, the counter is steered from state to state, what type of inputs will steer it from state to state as per this requirement, what combinational logic is required. That combinational logic we will produce in terms of gates today, but you know how to do it in terms of multiplexers or PROM. Do you understand? So totally we can do it finally together as a single compact solution. Now when you have all these signals, you have to defend some priority. What will happen if load and clear come at the same time? What will happen is count and load comes here, whether will count and load comes, will it count or will it load? All these values come. So let us define a priority of operation, because these are all in the data book. All this I am assuming in an arbitrary fashion. Once you decide which counter to use, all you have to do is to go to the data book and you look at all those features and how these features are interconnected to each other, how are they dependent on each other. So since I have to give you an example, I have to assume certain things before proceeding. So I am going to assume that clear has the highest priority. And it is non-synchronous. Okay, let us not make it non-synchronous, it is going to create problems. So let us assume all are synchronous. That means whatever you give to clear signal, whatever you give to the load signal, whatever you give to the up down, whatever you give to the count, the action will be only at the next clock edge. We will assume that. Okay. So it is a synchronous, all are synchronous operations. But when all the signals are present, in a confusing way, the counter will look at the clear signal. If it is 0, it will clear. So, because I put a bubble here, see, clear 0 clears it, clear 1 leaves it alone so that it can go through the rest of the operations. Then comes the load, 0 clears, 1 normal operation. Then comes the next priority is load. If clear is 1, that means it's a normal operation. Then if load is 1 and the clock pulse occurs, it will take the values of DA, DB, DC, DD and put it on the counter so that QA, QB, QC, QD will be same as DA, DB, DC, DD after the clock pulse. So loading is the next feature. It is a 1 loads, 0 normal operation. 1 loads what? Loads DA, DB, DC, DD into the counter. 0 means does not load, you do not have to write it. 0 does not load it. Then only the importance of count comes. If there is no clear, if there is no, that means if this is 0, this is 1 and this is 0. If this is 1 and this is 0, then count becomes significant, right? So count 1 is the next priority, count 1 counts up if up down is 1, down if up down is 0. That is why you put down bar. Down bar means, so if I put a 1 here and you decide this whether you want up or down, otherwise it does not know whether it should count up or count down. So that means there are different operations possible. I can load a new value, I can clear the existing value, or I can let it go up by 1 or go down by 1. These are the features available to me for me to implement this sequence using this particular 4-bit counter. So, what connections should I make to load, to clear, to count, to up and down for each case, and then you have to draw a table, the state table which becomes a transition table. So, since it next state is the same as that, it is a state table, but then all these inputs, extra inputs come, you know. So, it become a transition table and simplify the transition table to get the combination logic, and I am going to, as I said, do the gate solution today, because otherwise it will take some more time. So, I am going to put one condition, all these signals are synchronous, all these control signals are synchronous. What do you mean by synchronous? Synchronous means at the next clock edge, synergistic clock at the next clock edge. I may put a 1 here, does not mean that immediately this value will go in. It will only go in at the next clock edge. If I put a 0 here, but it will not clear immediately, it will clear only in the next clock edge. If I put a 1 and a 1 here, it will not count up immediately. If it counts up immediately, then there is no point. You know, I need to do it one after a time. So, with this background, let us draw the straight away the transition table. Transition table, of course, this is the state table really, state graph, except that I did not put circles, you know, the state graph, is it not? No other input. So, where is the question of drawing a separate state graph? So, transition table will have the percent count, percent state, which are A, B, C, D. Next state, which are A, B, C, D again, and you want to make it a distinction, make a distinction here by calling it, even though there are no signals, call A plus signal, B plus signal. And then what are the various things you need to give for this transition to happen? So, what should be the clear? What should be clear? We will put in the same order of priority, clear. What should be load, what should be count, should be 1 or 0, and what should be up down, should be 0 or 1. I am going to remove this line here, my working space I have to expand it now. If I had to load here, I should know what to load. So, what should be the value of DA, DB, DC, DD every time I want to load? I can't load arbitrary things, I have to load a correct thing. So, I should also write DA, DB, DC, DD. So, let us write a few things. I don't think we can do for the whole thing. I'll just draw 4 so that we will not make a mistake of. These lines are just required for me so that I can keep the same line. Nothing to do with the truth table. Okay. Okay, can you just read out from there? The percentage is 0, next state is 8, right? Correct? Percentage is 1, what is the next state? Not defined. 2, next state is 4. If somebody can give me, it will be great help instead of my having to turn in a horizontal direction, 180 degrees turn, 360 degrees turn. Okay, 0, 0, 1, 1. 5. 4, next state is? 5, next state is? 14 is 1110. Okay. 6, next state? 7, next state? 8, next state? 9, next state? 11, 10, next 10, 0, 11, 3, 12, not defined, 13, 14, 15, 15, 15. This is the next state. So, it is a state up to this is called state table. If you give the inputs also, it becomes a transition table. I think we have talked about these things several times. These lines are required for me to keep things without having to. Just make a grid so that you can write correctly without making mistakes. Okay, now if this is the thing, this is the, no, I cannot do it by, if the present state is 0, the next state is 8. I cannot do it by clearing, I cannot do it by up count, I cannot do it by down count, right? So, I need to load. So, now clear is priority, so highest priority, so I have to make sure it does not clear, that means I have to put a 1 in this. Cannot be don't care. Do you understand? If you put a don't care there, suppose it takes a value 0, then it will clear and I do not want that. Clear is the highest priority because I put it in the order of priority. So, it is a loading feature we want, so put a 1 on the loading. Count is don't care because since this is highest priority, higher priority, I can put a don't care on this. Do you understand? Count I can have don't care because load is a higher priority. Whereas clear I cannot put a don't care because it has higher priority than load, and if you put a 0 there, it will clear not load. So because of that, there is no need for any values for DA, DB, DC. Since I am not, oh, I have to give the load value. What is the value to load? It will load 1000. That is the new value. The next state is this, what you are going to load now. What you are going to load now is the next state. Next, don't care. It can be anything because even if it clears, there is no problem. If it counts up, no problem. Count down, no problem. Because when that state happens, we have to make sure that we go properly. So, this is a don't care condition. I can put all of them as don't cares. It could clear, for example, because don't care happened to be 0. It could load some value because it can be, load can be 1. So, some arbitrary values can get loaded, but since it is not a condition we are going to have, if the arbitrary value is a condition that we are having on a part of the count, then automatically the next state will be defined based on that. So I don't have to worry about a don't care state. I can give all of them don't cares. Is that clear? Whatever happens, it can get cleared, it can load a new value, it can count up, it can count down. But since this state is not defined, whatever the next state is assumes, from that state if you can proceed further, there is no harm done. Now, 1 to 2 to 4, again it's only a loading feature, 2 to 4 is a loading feature. Three to five is a loading feature. Four to six also is a loading feature. Mostly it's a loading feature. I did not choose anything; it is an arbitrary sequence I got. This is 5, this is 7, this is 14, right? So that is again a loading feature. Six, this is 7, count up feature. Of course, I can also, okay, can do the whole thing by loading feature also, does not matter. Just to show you, because this is a circuit I just took as an example, just to show you how to control various inputs, I am going to make it as a count up feature. I can do a load, no problem. So I am going to, so now I have to be very clear, it cannot be clear, it cannot load, because count up comes as a lower priority than load, so I have to make sure that it does not load by putting it as a 0. I cannot put a don't care, that is what I am trying to say here, I cannot put a don't care here. I want to put a load, right? I mean, I want to put a count up, which means count up 1, 1, and inputs have no meaning because it is going to count up. There is a question there, a potential question I can see in your face. You didn't get me. In what way? You know why it should be 1? I don't want to clear it, I don't want to load it, I want to, I could have loaded it, I am saying there are two ways I can do this 7, one is to load a value of 7, in this case I would have done like every way, the previous things, put a 1 here, don't care 7. I want to show you how to use other options, the other option being count up, since the value is 6 and the next value is 7, I can do a count up. And count up I have to do by putting a 1 here and a 1 here and make sure that it does not load, so I put a 0 here and when I am going to count up it does not matter what I connect to the inputs. Is that clear? This is 7 to 9 load. Eight to 2 load. 9 to 11 load. 10, here I want to use the clear option again. I can do load 0000. I can load 0000. Nobody prevents me. But I want to show you the other feature. I will never use the clear feature. I want to use a clear feature. I wanted to use a load up count up feature. I did it. Let me use the load clear feature. So when clear is there, I will have to make it clear, and when it is clear, it does not matter what the other, because clear is the highest priority input, it does not matter what is connected to the load, what is connected to this, what is connected to this, what is connected to this. This way also I have more don't cares in my table, is it not? More don't cares is better for my logic. This is 11 to 3 load, 12 to clear, again this is all don't care, this next, nothing is going to happen when you don't care it, because it might get cleared, worst case, okay, what if, might get a loaded a new value, what if, it can count up, but it can count down, whatever happens, we are going to go to a state which is already available, from there we know how to proceed. So this state is not going to occur, that is why you don't care. But if it does occur because of some transient or switching transient or anything, based on the condition of the clear or whatever, at that time it will go to another state which is a legal state, from there it will proceed. This is 13, 14, 15, I would like to do a count up, actually I would have done a count down, it would be nice, just to show you the difference. So can I make it different? Okay. If I make a change here, I should make a corresponding change here also, leave it. So 14 to 15 is a count up. Count up means it is no clear, no load, count up, this is a count up feature, 14 to 15 is a count up feature. This is loading feature, 15 to 10. Now I have to go and do a corner map for clear, I can do a ROM solution for this, it's an ideal candidate for ROM solution, because after all I need is a ROM, all I need is a size of the ROM, how much? 2 power 4, there are only 4 inputs, namely the present states, A, B, C, D, and the next states information is clear, load, no, we don't need this. I need to store only these values. I need to store the clear value for each of the present states. I need to know what is the clear, what is the load, what is this. So, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 2 power 4 times 8 is the simplest solution. So, I can have a ROM PROM solution. Size of the PROM, I will write it somewhere here. PROM solution is the simplest. Take it as an exercise, PROM solution for the power combination logic, size is 2 power 4 times 8, so address would be 0 to F, content, you read the content as whatever, you let assume that all don't cares are 0, something like that, otherwise you are going to be in error. So of course you can have anything, but generally we will assume that all don't cares are zeros. So it will be first byte would be 1100 1000, that means C8. Do you understand what I am saying? The first byte of the ROM, the first word of the ROM, PROM, the first address of the PROM should contain the content of the clear value, load value, count up down, DA, DB, DC, DD for that particular input combination. If the present state is 0, 0, 0, I want clear to be 1, load to be 1, count should be don't care, up and down should be don't care, DA should be 1, DB should be 0, DC should be 0, DD should be 0. I have to put it inside my PROM, it is a hardware truth table. Told you so many times, PROM is nothing but a hardware truth table. It is burn, as if I even said, like etching on silicon. So that means I need to put those values. So I can't put a don't care value, I have to put a 0 or a 1. I can put anything, but let us be uniform. When you are trying to understand the table, I would like to have it uniform. So for this purpose of a PROM implementation, I will assume all don't care should be zeros. So the content 000 is the address, the content corresponding to that address is 11001000, 8 bits 11001000. It is an 8 bit concatenated into hexadecimal form, first 4 bits is 1 hexadecimal, second 4 bits is another hexadecimal digit. So, first hexadecimal digit is 1100, which is C. Second 4 hexadecimal values is 1000, which is 8. Is what this C8 is? Because all of you are looking, staring at me as if I am talking Latin. We talked about these things earlier several times. Unfortunately, for you people, each class is an unit for you. Whatever I say in this class only, you will nod your heads. If I recall something which I said earlier, especially if it is 2 weeks earlier, that's it. You will stare at me as if I committed a crime. I used to check my hands. Are they bloody? Look at me as if I committed a crime. But just by reminding you what I taught you 2 weeks ago. Okay? Now with that background, please tell me the next table. What is the next content? 1. 1 will have? 0, 0. Good. Good class. One more and we'll stop. 2. Address 2 will have? 1100 0110. C4. Correct. And the last one? F. 1100 1010. C? CA. Correct. And in between, please fill. I give you homework and I end up doing it. That is the problem. Now let us get back to this rails on. Okay, problem solution, beautiful solution now I have, no? How is it going to be? Hardware wise. So I have a problem here. I have this 4-bit register. I have this 4-bit counter. I have this problem. Follow. Whose size is this? This fellow is here. These values are, this is A, B, C, D. I am assuming this A is MSB, D is LSB. So when you have to be careful which bit is what, otherwise it will reverse, you know. Now the values are the way in which I have put clear value, clear, load, up, count, up, down, DA, DB, DC, DD. Clear, load, maybe I will draw it a little bigger. Clear, load, count, up, down, D, A, B, C, D, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this is the address, this is the thing, and this goes into my counter, 4-bit counter. Which gives me the load feature, clear feature, clock of course, then I have this. More time I spend on this problem, the rest of the problem becomes your homework. Okay. Clear, this is count, up, down. DA, DB, DC, DD. So you have to match this. For example, clear should be connected to this, load should be connected to this, and this is DA, this is DD, etc. All those connections you make. And then the output ABCD are this ABCD. This is the present state, which becomes the next state address. So this A will connect it back to this. This B will be connected back to this. What an elegant solution. 4-bit register and a 4-bit counter, and a 2 × 4 × 8 ROM, and I got the whole circuit implemented. So digital design is a very, very elegant subject. Don't worry about Boolean algebra and lots of these gates, exclusive or NAND and all that. Of course, we need to learn those fundamentals. But today in the hardware, it's so simple to make. Right. So let us get on with our design. As I said, we'll do the gate-based design for this. So for each of these outputs, clear, load, count, up, down, DA, DB, DC, DD, you need to do a corner map and then implement it using logic. So I will do one. For example, up, down is one always. All don't cares, we assume one, this is don't cares. This is one. So straight away I can write up, down is same as count, which is always one. No logic, no simplification. This is for the coming back to the gate solution. That is the PROM solution. I finished it. This is the table. This is the PROM, the counter. PROM output controls the counter. Counter output controls the address of the. It's fed back as the address of the PROM. Here is this example where again the same thing I want to do. Instead of a PROM, I want to put individual gate-based solution because that is our traditional solution. We don't want to leave the traditions of this course. So let us do one or two, because already I have done these two. Load and clear seems to be, they seem to be easy. Let us draw clear. Clear, you draw the map. What are the values here? Quickly tell me. One, don't care. One. Somebody is going to tell me or not? No. No takers. 1101. This is the clear map. So that means I can almost combine everything. This one, this one, I have to have three terms, no other way I can reduce it. What? Rightmost one? Okay, do it this way. Three terms are required. I can make this one, this one and this one. Tell me somebody, what is clear? Quickly. This is what? This is A bar. This is A bar. This is B. And this is C bar. Is that right? One solution. D. Which is D? No. No, I said this. You said this. This. And this. Which one? I don't have to do everything. Why? This is there. This is what? This is B. This is A. Oh, this one is low. Okay, what do you want me to do? Another one more? Four terms are required. Are you sure? Okay, I will take your word for it. It is A bar B C C bar D. Give me a value for load, please.
quickly.
Everything is 1 except, see, so 1 don't care, 1 1, 1 1 0 1, 1 1 don't care 1, don't care 0 1.
Is that right?
So here I need to put this as 1 and this as 1. Okay, what else?
These two, one more, right? 3 terms are required.
It's equal to C bar 1 person.
C bar plus?
So first write B bar
plus?
C bar. Likewise, I have already written for up down, I have already written for count, I have done. You have to do maps for DA, DB, DC, DD. Then your circuit is going to be again the same way, except that it is going to be a little more complex. So, load, this is clock, load will be connected from the combination logic corresponding to load. It's a 3 input OR gate, right? I'll just show one. B bar, C bar, D. And then you have to have a clear. Put the corresponding map for that. Put the corresponding circuit for this. Then do the corresponding things for up and down is 1. Count is 1. Up down is 1. And then your DA, DB, DC, DD then these values will become DA, DB. ABCD that you are talking about here are the ABCDs here, right? The ABCD we are talking about in these maps are the outputs of the present state. Present state output combined with extra logic goes as inputs load, clear, up, down, count, DA, DB, DC, DD. You know how to do that. So please complete this exercise, complete that prompt table, and do one more thing. Instead of using a 4-bit counter, suppose you use a shift register. Repeat the problem. So your exercise is to complete the 2, it's mostly done. All you have to do is to do the DA, DB, DC, DD map. Here all you have to do is to complete the, this is the simplest, all you have to do is to complete that table. That is for completing this problem. I want you to repeat this problem using a 4-bit shift register instead of a counter. And you should know what are the features available for the shift register. Clock, of course, load, a new value of this can be loaded, clear if you want to, clear for negative signal, load for positive signal, say shift, and you will say left or right. If this is 1, it shifts I will put left bar right.
Conventionally, left shift is.
Oh, right is correct. This is right. Yeah, right is 1, left is 0. If you put a 0, it shifts left to 1 bit position. Put a 1, it goes right. Again, the same priority scheme will apply. First is low, if clear. If clear is 0, it gets cleared, irrespective of the value of load. Second priority will go to load, third priority will go to shift along with left and right. So, do the same problem there. So, this is an example of showing how to use sequential MSIs, because no circuit can exist as a combination logic. I told you many times, PROM is good and multiplexer based solutions are good, but unless you use them in a sequential circuit. Of course, we also saw how to use combination logic as part of sequential circuit, as steering logic, but the sequential circuit itself can be an MSI, counters or shift registers. Putting them together will be a nice combination of one or two chips for combination logic, mostly one chip for sequential logic, and interconnections very little. And going one step further, push the sequential logic flip flops into the combination logic and make a single IC in which there will be combinational building block and sequential building block, programmable array logic was an example. The other things I told you about CPLDs, complex programmable logic devices, and FPGAs, field programmable gate arrays, are examples of these things. So you have a single IC solution for a very complex digital system. That is how you see very simple chips. You know, today's electronics, anything you open, there will be so much inside, but IC will be very, very small. A small IC will be put somewhere. So example of computer chips, it contains a lot of combinational, a lot of sequential, but it's a single chip. With this, we will finish our discussion on all the building blocks, MSI, LSI, everything. So we need to go for system design. Of course, we have done the system design in many cases. We talked about this pattern generators, pattern checkers, and all that. And we'll also do some more system, practical systems, like a traffic light controller. How to design a traffic light controller. So a few examples we'll see based on the time available. Thank you.